Starry Night. Many years ago, Joseph and Mary traveled from Nazareth to Bethlehem to be counted in the census. Mary was expecting her first baby, and the journey was long and difficult. As Joseph led Mary, who was riding on a gentle donkey, the stars in the sky opened their hearts to the couple and filled their paths with light.
Bethlehem, along this dusty road, with happy heart I do my part to bear this heavy load. How far is it, I wonder, as starlight guides our way? We walk until we top the hill, then I hear Joseph say, "Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in that dark tree shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight."
When they entered Bethlehem, they looked for a place to stay for the night. But since many people had come to be counted, there was no room anywhere in town. When they arrived at the last inn, Joseph pleaded with the innkeeper to help them, since Mary's baby was about to be born. The kind and good innkeeper opened his heart to the couple and offered them room in his stable. However, when the animals heard that they had to make room for humans, they became very upset. Mayor Mouse was the first to speak.
Citizens of our
great and noble stable,
I have just heard the innkeeper talking. You won't believe he's moving in for the night. Humans! We must stop this outrage. I suggest we hang up a sign to keep these strangers out, just like the innkeeper did.
Sign. I think it said, "No vacations."
No vacation? No vacations? Who would go to Bethlehem on vacation anyway? I think it said, "No vaccinations."
No, that wasn't it. The veterinarian would never go for that. I think it said, "No vacuum cleaners."
No, that wasn't it. And this table could use a good cleaning. I think the sign said, "No vacancy."
That's it! No vacancy! We have no room in the stable!
We have no room in the stable! We have no room in the stable!
Thank you.
here. Does your stall have room?
There's no room anywhere.
As the unfriendly beast prepared to hang their no vacancy sign, the light of a single star filled the room, piercing the heart of Charity Chicken, filling her heart with compassion and love.
Citizens of the stable, this human family needs your help. The woman is about to have a baby.
Where would we put a human baby in this place?
Couldn't we put him in the manger?
In the manger? Well, that is where we store our hay. Where do we eat?
No, there is no room for them in the stable.
The unfriendly beast got louder and louder with her grumbling until Caroly Cow, who was expecting a baby of her own, called out to them.
Friends, friends, let's not behave like wild animals. Remember, we're refined, we're sophisticated, we're domesticated.
We have so much room. We have a warm stable with plenty to eat. These poor humans have nothing. Can't we share a home with them?
Let's show a little courtesy. Mind your manners and make room for the humans.
Mind your manners and watch your step. Let's fresh up on our stable etiquette. Work together in stable prep. Let's make room for the special guests.
As Mary and Joseph walked to the stable, the light of a thousand stars filled the room, opening the hearts of all of the animals. Then Sherry Sheep, Tiffany Lamb, and Grandpa Goat said,
"Last spring, when my woolen coat was so hot and heavy, a human sheared it off for me. I felt so much better after that. Now we have a chance to help some humans.
I was a little lost lamb until a shepherd came looking for me. Without his help, I would have been eaten by wolves. I'm glad that we can give something back to the humans."
"When I was a kid, my family had no home. We had to eat whatever was on the hillside. Cereal boxes, even tin cans. Now the innkeeper gives us a nice warm home and gives us plenty to eat. We must share it with the human family."
Thank you.
Mary and Joseph entered the little town in Bethlehem, where the animals warmly greeted them. It was there, on the holiest of nights, that Mary gave birth to her baby boy. She named him Jesus, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in the manger. Jesus was Emmanuel, the Son of God, the long-awaited Messiah. With their hearts filled with love for the Holy Child, the unfriendly beasts became the friendly beasts, and the animals sang of the special gifts that they would give to the baby. God loved the world so much that he gave us his son, Jesus, who is the light of salvation. If you believe in him with all of your heart, you will receive everlasting life. Will you open your heart to Jesus?
Before the finale, that's the finale song that they're about to sing. Can I hear another amen from the audience?
Yes.
Amen. Kids, you did a marvelous job tonight. Thank you very much. Have you noticed the awesomeness and the tremendous talents that our kids right here in Waterman have? Thank you, dear parents and grandparents. But we're going to just finish this program without the people behind these little kids. You know, to be dealing with these 3, 5, 7 year olds is very challenging. And it's not easy. They just practice for about 3 to 4 times until this presentation tonight. Isn't that marvelous? And so I'd like to, turn on the lights, please. I'd like to appreciate and recognize the cast this evening of this marvelous program by these little kids, the Unfriendly Beast cast, or Unfriendly Beast production. Yes. You have, okay, Val Ervin Bayita here is the narrator. All right. Then the Mayor Mouse, Sean Cabaluna. Just raise your hand. The grandpa goat, that's Blaine Dillard. See that old goat right there? The Karali cow, Aksa Istokada. Raise your hand, Aksa, please raise your hand. Then you have the Sierra sheep, Shaina Richards. And then the Tiffany lamb, Casey Fernandez. The charity chicken, Isabel Muraldi. Then you have Mary as Milena Alito. Joseph Varin Singelio. Nathaniel Donkey, Mark Irango. Innkeeper, Titus Godoy. Raise your hand, Titus. Raise your hand, right there. Talking animals, you have Eliza Dislati, Jaron Smadia, and then you have Ava Istokada. Okay, let's go to the animals. Animal one, James Galeao. Animal two, Zach Elizondo. Animal three, Gax Elizondo. Animal four, Joseph Samson. Animal five, Mackenzie Alido. Animal six, Braden Quijada. The rest are just plain animals. Thank you, kids. Thank you. And I'd like to thank, of course, our pianist tonight, Crystal May Lau. And then for the decorations right here, that's Ray and Michelle Istokada, Richard and Lierda Balinton. Then, of course, the fashion design or costumes by Mitch Elizondo and Ailey Moraldi. They are also the coordinators, Ailey, Lierda Gay Balinton, and April Quijada. Of course, we would like to thank these beautiful lights right here. These are LED lights. You have seen this last Sabbath, but that was not the final lights. These are the final lights donated by Bliss and Ronette Francisco. Thank you, Bliss and Ronette. Then, of course, we have the video coordinator. That's Denzel May Wheeler, also with live streaming. We were seen online throughout the world tonight, this presentation. Then we have the audio by Calvin Galeao over there. And of course, the wonderful microphones. Those are brand new microphones, wireless. Just for this program, they were donated by Dr. Oliverio, 8 of them. Thank you, Dr. Oliverio, for these brand new wireless microphones, so our kids will be able to really harness their talents, because they cannot be tripped anymore by these lines that we have. And of course, I'd like to thank the production of these Waterman kids, these uninvited or unfriendly beasts. But without this, we cannot just forget our directors tonight. The directors. We have the mother and daughter directing this cast or this program tonight. We have Marivic Urango, and of course, Gilanil Marie Urango, or Sweetie. I'd like him to please stand. Marivic, can you please stand right here? And Sweetie. Now, before they will sing the finale, the final song, these kids are being nurtured and taught right in some of our facilities here that are not really as convenient as other churches are. We are in need of more rooms for these kids. And hopefully early next year, 2016, we will be able to accomplish that. But that will be also with your help tonight. So if you can just extend your help for these little kids in praises to the Lord as well as for the church, there's an envelope in front of you, right there behind you. in front of you, right where the rocks are. Get that envelope, write a check, pay to Waterman Church, whatever your donation for the church building project that we will be having before we will receive that tonight. And so, get ready with these envelopes. We appreciate them, but we can do a greater service for them by also helping them on their behalf for the church and for the community as well. Now, I'd like to request Crystal May to play the offertory as the ones that are being assigned for the offering to pass the bags while they receive the offerings.